here, Armenia. A very good evening, everyone. Today, I hope every one of you have filled up your stomach before coming here. Standing here today, I, Daphne Yeong-Sing, 12, would like to deliver a speech entitled Don't Give Up, Magic. So sit back, relax, and enjoy this inspiring story. Before I begin with my story, I would like to share with you the meaning of the word inspirational. According to the Oxford Dictionary, the word inspirational is defined as the process of being mentally stimulated to do or feel something. So who inspired me in my life? To be honest, there's lots of people who inspired me. My family members, teachers, friends, and maybe those famous people like Albert Einstein. However, today, I am not going to talk about them. Instead, I am going to talk about a lady. A lady who has been seeing me grown up from a little girl. This lady, whom I only acknowledge her as my chick, has been setting up her stall strategically in front of a convenience store. Almost every morning before my loving parents send me to school, I will definitely make a pit stop at my favorite magic store. Why do I say she's my favorite magic? Well, because I'm a traditional kue lover. I do believe there's kue lover here too. May I know who are they? That's great! I love eating curry puffs. The curry puff that magic made is crunchy on the outside and filled with potato savory inside. So delicious! Other than curry puffs, Machik also sells kueh kataya, the green in colored kueh filled with coconut fillings in it. Every bite I take, the coconut filling is like oozing out. So delicious! I actually have been a loyal customer since I was 7 years old. I remember there's 2 weeks when Machik did not operate her store. Did something bad happen to her? I don't know. All I know is that I miss buying my breakfast from her. 2 weeks later, she finally opened back her store. As curious as a cat, I asked her, Majid, where have you been for the past 2 weeks? Only able to plaster a smile, she answered. Oh, my son was admitted to the hospital because of health issues. I was taken aback for her response. I asked her, is he okay now? He is still in the hospital, waiting for someone to donate an organ for him. She said before breaking into tears. I was so touched by her story. For me, despite raising a son with liver failure, the single mother did not give up. She worked really hard to earn enough money to able to pay for his son expensive medical expenditures. Before my conversation ended, Machi, she told me, don't be sad for what had happened. Instead, look forward, for every day is a new start. It has been years since I saw Machi. I hope that she's still as cheerful as I know her. So everyone here, don't be sad for what had happened. Instead, look forward, for every day is a new day. Thank you. I hope you love my inspiring story.